two threes and two layups and got him out of it. You know, tonight, obviously, we couldn't make anything for a long time. We had to drive, we had to try to get in the lane and make something happen, and we didn't really finish very well in there. You know, when you play against zones and you don't make shots, it's a difficult game. I thought Frank made a couple good penetrations in the second half. We got in the lane, and we wanted Ty in the corner. Ty hit the one shot that we needed to have. I think that gave us separation. But, you know, it's a struggle for us some games to score points. And when that happens, you just have to play defense and do the best you can at the other end. Barama was tremendous. He's been getting better in practice, healthier. He had his best practice of the year this week. I didn't anticipate him playing that much, but Pascal was not involved in the game at all. He wasn't doing what he's been doing, catching, going strong. He was looking. But Barama was tremendous. I still think if he had been healthy all year, he could do this on a regular basis. He's a very good player down there. He gets a little overexcited. He fouled the guys on a three-point shot at the end, but you know, that's he tries to make plays. I thought he was tremendous today. He was the difference in the game. I thought we did a good job on Parker. You know, he can shoot it, but. We get off to a slow start like we did against Boston College, and we kind of battle our way back in it. But at the end of the day, you got to make some shots. We didn't finish. O'Shea is not finishing around the basket. We got to do a better job there. But you go on the road, it's tough. I don't care where you're playing, who you're playing. I thought their fans were good today. You know, I thought they played hard. I thought they did some good things. But at the end, Tyus made that shot, and then we made a couple good defensive plays and got just enough separation.
Jim, did Merritt getting the ball in the high post a little bit more help you guys out in the second half too?
Well, you know, he didn't do much in the first half from there. He made a great pass to O'Shea. O'Shea was rushing the shot. He took his time, made that three. Those were the two big shots, that shot and the time made. But he's usually pretty good in the high post. I thought Frank did a good job in the second half of getting in the lane. And he got the wild pass. Frank struggled shooting. We struggled putting the ball in the basket. And whenever you do that, you're going to have trouble. We had trouble in Syracuse, so we played in Pittsburgh and Syracuse, so it was virtually the same kind of game. It was close. And we made a couple of shots and got the lead. Today, if we didn't just go foul the guy out there twice, we probably would have had it kind of about the same game as we had in Syracuse. But, it's a very difficult game.
In your experience, Jim, have you seen the team play as many freshmen in significant minutes as we've been playing this season?
You can't win with just freshmen, so it's impossible. I think I watched them play a number of games, and I know they hit their battle last three times. They had NC State really just about beat the other day. NC State won in North Carolina today. So, they're playing as hard as they can. They're doing what they can to win. They got too many young guys out there. That's our problem. We have the same problem. And it shows up, but we've got a couple of veteran guys, but it shows up, no question.
Jim, is this the kind of game that can maybe propel Barama as the season goes on, or do you have to wait and see how the tendonitis
is? I think it's health. If his knee's healthy, I think he would. But Pascal's been great. He's been really good for us, and he needs to learn from this experience. Can't go out there and play like that. We played 17 minutes and we got a couple of rebounds, but we didn't do anything around the basket. We had good opportunities. You got to score inside if they're not guarding.
Jim, I'm going back a few decades here, but I'm kind of wondering, given this was a retro night and they had Charles Smith here, if you remember what the Pitt program was like prior to his arrival, Charles Smith's arrival at Pitt in the early 80s with the Big East?
Yeah, I mean,
and how much of an impact a guy like that can make?
They weren't very good. They, you know, Charles and Jerome, those guys turned it around. We had a pretty good record against Pittsburgh for a long time, but those guys really turned it around. That when Ben came in, he did a great job. Jimmy did a great job.
Jimmy, they shot 27%. You talked about Stewart, but what else did you do defensively better than you did in the last game?
You know, we found Stewart. That's really what we did. I think the thing with Frame made those four or five shots early, and then he probably didn't make more than one the rest of the game. He must have been like 2 for 14 or something. But sometimes you make a couple early, it's not good. You know, you think you're going to keep making them. We did a good job on Stewart. When you really watch a guy for a long time and then he does get an open shot, it's hard to make that open shot when you haven't had one. And he had a couple finally. But one time he had one, and Tyus was right there and he let him shoot it. That's the one he made. I don't know what he was thinking. But, you know, we do things that I can't figure out. And, you know, I know it's because they're young. Things you can't do, but they keep trying, they keep playing, they keep scratching away, and that's really all you can do. That's all you can ask for.
Coach, how impressed were you winning this game with only two guys on your bench? It's five players on the bench.
Yeah, we only have seven guys, so we know that coming in. We played seven the last game for just about the whole game. You only need five. Everybody's healthy. You can get by.
During your all's preparation for this game, Jim, given what Stewart did against you guys 10 days ago, how much more of an emphasis or a focus was there on in defense?
Well, there was a big focus. We wanted to play him. We wanted to find him. We didn't do that. We did it. We did really good against him. But, kept them in the game. The other guys didn't play very well. They played. Defense was better. They were better around the basket. I thought we got in there. I thought O'Shea got in there. And I thought Marek got in there. And they just couldn't finish. And Brahma, who hasn't played all year, he finishes. He's good. He uses his left hand. He's sneaky. He actually missed that one layup. He would have had 20-16. But he was spectacular. I thought you know, it was pretty quiet. I thought he had like 12 or 10. But looked at the stats here. I guess good thing I didn't take him out.
Jim, you said in years past that this was a tough place to play, but a lot of it had to do with the team. The team was a tough thing to play against.
You don't play against buildings or fans. You play against teams. They've had some great teams here. We've had some great games here that we couldn't quite get done. They've had a really good run of players. This is a tough building because it's smaller and more noise than these kind of buildings. But in our league, really, now every place you go, it's pretty tough. But it comes down to players. We made two plays, and they had two chances at the other end to answer. And I think Marek made an unbelievable block on one of them. And I think Shea made one block on that. You know, we made a couple really big defensive plays, and that was the difference. You know, just in a game like this, it's a couple plays. That's what it is. The end of the Florida State game, we hit a block one shot. We were one man. We just couldn't make that. We didn't make the play.
Jim, how bad is Matt's ankle? Is there any chance he plays on Wednesday?
No, I don't think so. He's out for a while.
Jim, what was the issue that Frank was having in the first half? It seemed like he wasn't on the same page with what you wanted out of him.
You think so?
Just from watching
is
you.
Is that a question or is that an observation?
Why did he get subbed out in the first half? for those 4 or 5 minutes.
You need a rest. You can ask me any question you want. I just don't want to hear your observation. You go on talk radio and do that, all right? For the rest of this.
Jim, how would you evaluate Tyus' play today and overall his shooting the past few games?
You know, he's been great. I think they matched up with him, and I didn't do a good job of getting him in different places. We moved him finally to the other corner, and he got the three there. But he's got to be more aggressive. He was not aggressive in the second half. I think he's got three shots. That's not enough. You know, he's got to get more shots. But when you're playing against a matchup zone, you're staying with him like we stayed with Parker, then you're going to get stuff inside, and we weren't very good in that. Marek had a bad start, Pascal had a bad start, O'Shea had a bad. I mean, those guys are getting layups. One's 4 for 16, one's 0 for 4. You know, the other's 2 for 6, so we're 6 for 26. In there, inside. You can't do that. You can't be 6 for 26 inside. You can't put Tyus there. This guy's got to finish better in there. And, but, you know, I thought there was a couple times he could have moved into a different spot. But they stayed with him. They guarded him. And you can do that in the zone. You can take a guy away, and that leaves an opening someplace else. And, you know, we didn't take as much advantage of that as we needed to. But when you shoot 3 for 15 from the three against the zone, and, you know, 19 for 54, it's not
going to
be easy.
It's going to
be hard.
It's going to
be very hard.
Jim, how tough is it for Kevin to try to turn this around and see the start he's had this year?
Well,
he's got a young
team. When he came, you know, you missed that year, and you know, he had two or three veterans, but they were there, you know. Now you're starting all over. Playing all young guys. You just can't win it in this league. Playing those guys. They're playing hard. They're doing the things they got to do. They're moving the ball. They had good opportunities against us. We blocked a couple layups, and they missed a couple open threes, and we made a couple open threes, and that was the difference in the game. And NC State's really good. I didn't watch the whole game, but they led after the game. They had an 8-10 point lead. NC State looked like a world championship team today. Carolina played good.